So next up, Purdue University has been as an academic partner, has been kind of the longest standing within the Battery Innovation Center. Myself, Purdue grad, among several others that attended Purdue University there, so I'll say boiler up to our team. But Purdue's been a huge, has been a huge supporter. Has brought, technical talent to us along the way, interns and others. Have been a part of some of our education initiatives as well. But we also have gotten some unique opportunities lately to share in some common initiatives within the state of Indiana. So excited to bring Vikas Tomar, who's a professor at Purdue University and is responsible for one of those programs that we're collaborating on along with Vilas Pohl. So I'll bring him to the stage, if you would help me welcome Vikas to share a little bit more about what's happening there.
Thank you, Ben. It's certainly my pleasure to be here. I am going to talk about our work at Purdue. This is what. Okay. So basically, what we are, our mandate at Purdue is not only research or selling stuff, but we also want to educate and educate great leaders like Ben and many others who are meeting today. And in that process, we want to develop basic technologies that can be used in the market or can be developed in collaboration with places like BIC or Naval Surface Warfare Center. So currently we have big collaborations going on with BIC, Naval Surface Warfare Center, and our team has been working with Cummins and other big threes of automobile industry as well. So this is a plot that I try to show every time when we talk about our team. So we are focusing not only on developing basic technologies, but also implementing that into different industrial settings. So this is a good circle where we try to not only work in the basic workings of the batteries, but I guess I've love to have a pointer, but I don't know how it's okay. So the way I talk, actually, I love to have a pointer. So I don't have pointers. I would like to you to basically focus on the middle part. So that's our hypothetical battery. And our team is actually trying to look inside the batteries and then try to get the information from that and develop new types of battery materials, new types of diagnostic technologies, and try to do it in a way that it creates impact not only with the national labs, but with the industry as well. And in that process, we also want to have our basic mandate that we want to educate next new leaders in this technology. So one of the things that I'm going to give you a couple of examples, and both examples are in partnership with mostly Office of Naval Research and Battery Innovation Center and the corresponding industries. So one of the problem that we are facing in the batteries is that we are developing new technologies, but batteries in the conventional sense are failing. And be it the personal use, personal equipment, or into the defense equipment. And it's not only the failure of the batteries, but the systems that contain them, and there's a big collateral damage issue with that. So this seems to be the big impact area, and then we are working heavily with the NSWC Crane and BIC in that area. So so this is one of the first program that I'm gonna talk about. So this is an educational program, and we have started working with Office of Naval Research on Naval Research Laboratory, and then BIC and Naval Surface Warfare Center. You will see various people engaged in there. And what we are trying to do is to look inside the batteries when the batteries are failing, and then try to develop the technologies that will predict in advance those failure when they happen. And then take those technologies through to the marketplace in partnership with organizations like BIC. So, this is the figure that I use to get students excited. And we have seen many such examples that are happening. So what we are doing in our lab to predict these failures is actually trying to design substitute designs or meta batteries into the lab and try to look inside those batteries when the real operational conditions of the battery operation is going on. Now, one of the challenges that we are facing when we are doing these types of experiments and models is that battery safety, everybody wants battery safe, but there are no unified standards. And that's where there's a big impact point, and I would like all of us to think about it. So when we started thinking about safer batteries, and there are at least five different types of standards, and none of them agree with each other. So in that case, it's very difficult to come out with a battery and then say with a complete confidence that this battery is going to keep the passengers safe or the transportation equipment safe. So this is a big challenge that we are working on. What we have done is that we actually take the realistic batteries and shock them and then try to develop new types of sensors that they will be able to predict beforehand that, this is the time to stop drawing power from the batteries and you better stop it. So this is a picture, it's very busy, but what we are trying to say is that we have designed new breeds of sensors which can actually predict. Right now, the sensors that try to predict the battery failure have microsecond lag, and then we have produced at least 8 to 10 times improvement in those prediction accuracy in our labs. So that's a big improvement that we have done. Now, another program that we have recently launched is to not only take our educational mandate, but to use Purdue as an incubator of new technologies, where we collaborate with BIC as an applied lab and SWC as a supporting federal lab, where we actually develop an ecosystem which can be used to translate these technologies to help companies like Cummins and other. So I think Cummins is one of the partners here as well. So this is also sponsored by Office of Naval Research, and then ultimately our aim is to standardize the safety domain. So the one challenge that all the battery innovators I would like to pose is that most of the batteries, when we make them, we test them under quasi-static conditions. Their charging, their efficiency is always calibrated under quasi-static conditions. But we are using these batteries into different scenarios like impact or shock or vibrations. So do we have a standard? Can we develop new types of standards where we can say, okay, well, if you satisfy that particular standards, you'll be safe. So this is a challenge that we are posing in this particular project. So this is a big team, and then we have Dr. Vilas Kohl, who is a big innovator in battery materials, that's me, and then Professor Mukherjee. So, and then we are collaborating all across Indiana with support for Indiana Economic Development Corporation. And then obviously our focus is on educating students and then providing leadership pipeline to the industry that is present here. So, I'll in the next few slides, I'll give you an overview of what are the basic technologies that we are working on. So besides the sensor and prognostic capability, we try to develop new types of materials, and then in that process, we not only develop materials that are useful for batteries, but these materials can also be applied in different scenarios. For example, here there is a slide, you see those colorful balls. They are basically carbon nanosphere. And they have been shown to significantly reduce the thermal runaway in batteries that are undergoing failure. But at the same time, these have been used as a lubricant and to develop new types of lubricants inside the automobile brakes. So basically, a new type of lubricant is in development, which can actually reduce the wear and tear almost 10 times. So this is a kind of derivative technology, but this is an example of fundamental basic research advancement that is being done, besides the applied work that I just talked and training of the students, that can be applied to various industries into single setting. So more onto this, and this is a R&D funded award winning technology for the same reason. And so the one good example of this material being very useful for the batteries, you can see that the use of this material significantly reduces the thermal loss and reduces the possibility of thermal runaway. Another component that we try to have as part of, besides the applied sensing and applied prediction capabilities and the materials capability, is to have a support for the computing world. So when we are training students, we also have this luxury of having basic human resources, which we can use to support industry in terms of computational work, in terms of analysis, which can be done in-house at a very low cost. So this is a good collaboration that is going on. So this is Professor Mukherjee and our team. So we are able to actually look into the realistic batteries. For example, this is one good example where the battery, external battery temperature is used to model what is going on inside the batteries. And we can use this information to go inside how would the microstructure of basic electrodes will affect the battery operation, and then how we can use that knowledge into the applied world, such as the one that I talked about earlier. And one good thing that we have seen is that not only producing basic information, but translating that to the realistic operation. So these models are high throughput models, and we can take a back of batteries and then try to scale up these models to predict failure in automobile scenario. So in short, our key emphasis is our partnership. I forgot about this slide. So this partnership is it's a public, private, and national partnership. So we are trying to partner not only with private entities like Cummins, but semi-private like BIC, and then we are at Grand University, and at the same time we are also working with defense. Because just like our previous speaker talked about, most of the new technologies, new and advanced technologies can come with the federal laboratory partnership. So we have a significant presence there. So for example, we are also working with the manpower that goes into the federal labs, and we are partly responsible for the training of that as well. So this is one example. And so in short, Purdue is at a place where we can act as an incubator for the new technologies. We are trying to supply new human power in terms of training and new development, as well as we are looking for partnership with the public as well as private industry to advance new startups and create new startups in Indiana. So thanks for listening, and then welcome to discuss.